Hello everyone. Hi. This is K. Praveen Kumar Reddy, working as assistant professor in Triple Department R&D Engineering College, Chennai. I'm going to explain a small topic in the subject of basic electrical and instrumentation engineering. This subject is according to the Anna University syllabus. Okay. So in that subject, basic electrical and instrumentation engineering, I am going to explain today a small topic in the first unit. This is your syllabus framed by Anna University. And in this, I am going to explain the topic of transmission and distribution of electrical energy, which is in unit one, in the basics of AC circuits and power systems. There is a topic called as transmission and distribution of electrical energy and single line diagram. Okay, a topic related to that. So what is that transmission and distribution of electrical energy? So generally, as electrical engineers, of course, as a customers, we get power to our home, we get 230 volts or 400 volts or 440 volts to our plug points in our home. So where from that power comes, how it is getting generated, and what is the process where the power plant which generates the power is very far away from our houses. Like you can see in different states, you can think about the power plants which you know. Okay, so somewhere a far distance, around the hundreds of kilometers, the power plant is there, and from that power station or generating station, the power is getting transmitted through overhead transmission lines or underground transmission lines and comes to our homes. So when we transmit the power through overhead transmission lines, we have some few steps or process is done in between. There are some other things that happens in between. So to explain that, let us see this picture, consider this picture. So this picture explains the entire system, power system, where from the power gets started, how it is generated. That is the first thing if you see here is power plant which generates the electricity. So there are various types of power plants. So you might have heard hydro power plant, thermal power plant, which is written at the bottom of the screen. Thermal power plant, hydro power plant, wind power plant, solar power plant, and geothermal power plant. Various kinds of resources are used to generate the power. Okay, so various natural resources are used to rotate the turbines and generator present inside the power plants. Okay, so let's assume generally in Indian scenario, this power which is generated at the power station, it will be like generally it will be 11 kV. Okay, 11 kV is the voltage. Normally it is generated at the big generator inside the power plant. But the voltage we get at our homes is either 230 volts, either 230 volts, or it can be 400 volts, line to line voltage. Okay, 230 volts or 400 volts we get. Then how this 11 kV is becoming 230 volts or 400? And also, this 11 kV is not transmitted as it is. What we do in this system is, power systems, we use one, we step up that 11 kV to a higher voltage. This is the transformer symbol shown in the picture, which transformer steps up the voltage for transmission. This generally we step up this voltage from 11 kV to generally it can be a 33 kV or 66 kV or 132 kV. Let us assume I step up this voltage to a very high value like 132 kV. Okay, so why should I do this stepping up 11 kV why can't I transmit as it is 11 kV? Why should I step up? There is a reason behind it. Okay, so 132 kV is transmitted on these overhead transmission lines. We will be having 132 kV, very high voltage transmission. Okay, sometimes we go for 400 kV also. Let's assume here 132 kV. So why should we do this is, we have to understand the basic things, basic electrical concepts. So we know the power transmission. For example, let me explain that. Power transmission, that is the load connected to the this power system, that is power required, that is transmitted to the load side, is nothing but voltage generated and current dragged by the conductors. Okay, so when I will try to reduce this current value, because if the current value is very high, the conductors will get much heated because of the I square R losses. Power also can also be written in the other ways. We can write I square R. P is equal to VI or P equal to I square R. So if you, this is called as copper loss, which is going in the terms of heat gets generated in the conductors. So what we try to do is, we will increase, to minimize this current, we will increase this voltage to a very high value, so that this current value will be decreased and the product of these two, P is constant. Okay, if you assume load is constant, that is the load at the other the receiving end is constant. If I increase the voltage, I can reduce the current that is passing in the conductors. Advantage here is, if I reduce the current value, this I square term will drastically reduce, and heat getting generated in the conductors, that is transmission lines, is very much minimized. And I can, so when I reduce this current value, I can use smaller conductors. Okay, smaller conductors, smaller or thin conductors for transmitting power. If I don't follow this method, if I transmit 11 kV as it is to deliver to that same load, the current value will be very high, because V is 11 kV only. Current value will be very high, and the conductor size what I have to use will be very high. So to minimize the conductor sizes, we go for stepping up the voltage to a very high value. Okay, so now that is transmitting at 132 kV on these transmission lines, and it is received to the city. Okay, this distance will be around 100 kilometers or 200 kilometers from here to here. It will be something like 200 kilometers or distance. Okay, long transmission lines. So when it reaches to city of maybe Chennai or Hyderabad, you can think. So again, this 132 kV has to be stepped down to the required value by the for the customer. So customer requires, all the equipments of the customers are designed to operate on 230 volts. So I have made it 132 kV stepped up. So again, I have to step down it. So I will use a step down transformer at the receiving end, at the customer end, steps down. Okay, this is steps down the voltage, step down transformer, like 132 by this may be like 33 kV. I will reduce it to 33 kV or 66 kV. Okay, first I'll step down to one level, 66 kV, or I can reduce it to 33 kV. It cannot be done at one step, so I'll use step by step reduction. Then I will have some other distribution transformers where I'll again reduce it to 11 kV, and from 11 kV I'll step down it to 400 or 230 kV. Okay, so I'll step it down step by step by using different range of transformers, and from that 400 volts I'll give to the customer house, or I can give 230 volts I will give to the customer. Okay, that is what the process happens. So the point we have to understand here is, why should we step up and why should we step down? The reason behind is the basic formula, P is equal to VI. If I increase the voltage, current value can be minimized. If I minimize the current value, smaller conductors can be used because it can be minimized. Okay, so this is the story. Now, the same picture is shown as a single line diagram in the textbooks. This entire picture, like as it will not be comfortable to draw like this, so we will show that as a single line diagram, either like this or we can say vertically like this. So first thing is the power station generator, next step up transformer, that is 11 kV by 132 kV, and this is your transmission line. Okay, this is your transmission line, and so this after transmission line of 200 kilometers distance, then you are using a step down transformer from 132 to back to 11 kV, or depends on the customer, whether the customer may be normal household people, normal customer, or maybe industrial customer. Okay, so you may step it down one more time, 33 by 3.3 kV, depends on the customer requirements. We will step down the voltages because industries may need some 3.3 kV or in the high voltages, like in kilovolts. Okay, depending on the customer, we step down the voltage and give it to them. Okay, so 3.3 kV primary distribution. So one more distribution transformer, step down to 440 or 230 volts. This is secondary distribution. Okay, like normal houses. So consumers connection. This picture is nothing but this thing. This thing is shown as a, on the paper we show like a diagram like this. This diagram is called as single line diagram. So entire system we are showing it as a single line diagram. Okay, so this is the meaning of the transmission and distribution and single line diagram. So hope you got the basic idea. Thank you very much for listening. Thank you.